Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon all my viewers. Today, I would like to tell you 2-3 points regarding the campus placement interviews or the job interviews that you may face in your life. So the very first point that I would like to highlight here is regarding the GD sessions, the group discussion sessions. In the GD sessions, when you are given a particular topic, keep in mind that you are not supposed to be just on a particular side. Don't be either too much positive or just negative, okay? At least keep in mind that you are not supposed to be negative at all. Even if there are certain negative points, then present them in a positive way. It will have a positive impact on the recruiter. He will feel that this guy, that if some problem arises in the company, then this guy will provide a solution to it and not just fight for it, okay? So be humble, be polite, and present all the negative points in a good and polite way, in a positive way. The second point that I would like to tell you is that show your dedication to the recruiter. Show your dedication that you want to work with their company. Show them, or just inquire, or you should also know beforehand that what are the benefits that you will get by working in their company. So you can tell them that, sir, I want to work in your company because of the following reasons. These are the benefits that I am getting. These are my dream jobs, okay? What normally happens is the newly joining candidates, they work in the company for 2 to 3 months. Then after 2-3 months, if they get a higher package than their current company, then they just leave the job and join the different company. So this creates problem for the recruiter. So what they want is whenever a candidate comes in the company to work, he should work for a long time, maybe for 1 year or 2 years or something like that. So you have to show them your dedication to him, that the job they are offering, you are extremely thirsty for that and you want that job, and that job is very important to you. If you will show them this kind of attitude, then if you will have some shortcomings, then too they will select you. Maybe I have that kind of experience. I will tell you my story in the next video, what has happened to me. If I ever make a video, I will share with you my personal experience, what happened to me when I went for the interview. Then the third thing that I would like to tell you, that even if you don't get selected for the interview, don't be nervous. Because what happens is, those recruiters that come to recruit you, they judge the candidates according to their own requirements. What requirements they have in their company and what conditions they have in their company, they will judge you according to that, okay? A candidate may be very good, but what the recruiter may think, that he is not going to fit for the job that I have come here for. So he won't select you. So sometimes it may happen that you may feel that the another guy that got selected was not better than me. Still he got selected. So there is nothing negative in that. Those recruiters, they are experienced people. They know very well what kind of child they want. Okay. So if you don't get selected, keep in mind that that man has understood that you were not the correct person to work there. It does not mean that you don't have the different skills or you are not better than others, okay? It's just something that you don't fit at that place. So just go for the different interviews, and wherever you will get selected, they will select you for the right job, okay? And always be truthful in all your answers, because that is going to help yourself only in future. If you will lie a lot, then you will get selected for the job, and afterwards when you join there, you won't find the working environment fitting you, okay? So be prepared that whenever you will get a job, the job should be according to your own requirements and what you want. It should give you a satisfaction.